Hi, I'm Sarah Borders with Benefits Compliance Solutions. Recently, the departments, HHS, DOL, and Treasury issued the interim final regulations related to sort of phase one of the implementation of the No Surprises Act. Now, you'll remember that back in December 2020, that sweeping budget legislation, the CAA, was passed, which contained the No Surprises Act. And so the departments are issuing their rules related to actual implementation of this new law. So what these rules talk about, and they're quite extensive, is first of all, they talk first about how the member or the individual is supposed to be applied their cost share, so their deductible or out of pocket. And so how a plan is to determine that amount is they will look at three different methods, and they will use one of these three methods based on whether it's available or not. The first one is the all payer method, which really deals with how CMS and Medicare pays and the contracted rates with that structure. Then if that isn't available, then they look at the state law and any contracted rates there. If that's not available, then they move on to basically the median contracted rates within the plan and the provider or the facility. And so it can get pretty technical. Obviously the carrier or the TPA has this knowledge and this data, and they will have to be the ones interacting with the providers and also with the members and applying that correct cost share. It also goes through how the providers and the plan are supposed to get to a number that they both kind of agree on. And that's very high level generalization, but that's basically what's happening here. There's also a notice requirement that will have to be attached into the explanation of benefits and also in a publicly available website. And so if you have specifically a self-insured plan, you're going to want to make sure that your TPA and your claims administrator are on top of this and making sure that they are going to be in compliance, because no cost sharing or no balance billing, excuse me, can be applied in any emergency services, either facility or provider, whether in or out of network. And for non-emergency services that are in an in-network facility given by an out-of-network provider, so think radiologists, anesthesiologists, etc. So this goes into effect January 1st, 2022. So we'll need to start planning for this, especially if you are self-insured right now. So if you have any questions, please let me know. Thanks so much for watching.